Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. We'll now talk about the ideas of Tmax and Cpmax. Determining PK parameters requires both IV and oral CP time data. We've seen how IV data are useful for determining half-life. What do we use oral data for? Two things we can determine are Cpmax and Tmax. On the screen is our oral time curve. Our lumpy curve. On the left of the curve, we see the absorption phase. The CP builds to a peak. This peak corresponds to Cpmax on the y-axis. It occurs at Tmax. On the x-axis, I'm going to read this Tmax as around 8 hours, which is higher than most real drugs. Tmax is normally around 2 to 3 hours. I do not have units listed on the y-axis, but if we had units, we could read the Cpmax value. For an orally administered molecule, Cpmax is the peak concentration in the entire curve. Cpmax touches upon the idea of exposure. For drugs, the most common way to quantify exposure is AUC, area under curve. AUC combines the questions of how much and how long into one single value. Cpmax, on the other hand, is an instantaneous glimpse into how much. Tmax tells you when the how much occurs. We will not discuss Cpmax or Tmax much, but they can be affected in various ways. If a molecule is administered to an animal in a fasted state with an empty stomach, then Tmax may be shorter and Cpmax may be higher. Likewise, administering medication with food may slow absorption, lengthen Tmax, and decrease Cpmax. Furthermore, how the oral drug is formulated can impact both Tmax and Cpmax. Factors like particle size of the molecule, is it a fine powder or crystalline solid, compression of the oral pill, and coatings on the pill can slow down absorption. If the molecule needs to act quickly, a shorter Tmax would be desirable. Is Cpmax relevant for molecules dosed by IV bolus? It can be. Here is the CP time curve for IV dosing. Note that the CP peaks. We hit Cpmax at the time of the injection. In the first instant, the entire dose is in the central compartment, the circulatory system, the plasma. Most molecules quickly distribute. So CP quickly drops to a degree as the elimination phase begins. Calculations of Cpmax for IV administration often give a predicted Cpmax that is too low because it is based on extrapolation of the elimination phase back to T0. But Cpmax is generally quite a bit higher at the initial time of injection. In fact, Cpmax can be much, much higher depending on the specific compound. If the molecule has acute toxicity concerns at high CP, then multiple smaller doses or a prolonged injection time, like an IV drip or IV infusion, may be necessary. I hope you found this video helpful. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment or question. Take care.